You're in the public eye. Keep your uniforms nice at all times.
Okay, Chris Hokiang is the brother, which is the older truck. Tomarere is the sister, which is the younger truck.
Yes.
You got to do it as soon as you turn it on?
Yeah.
And we'll meet them by the road, and then what your job is to get those people safely onto the trucks.
Oh, nice.
So the Union Mark is quite a unique vehicle. I look at it as a tractor on steroids. A lot of the north gets cut off in big floods. As you can see over here in this area, the roads are rugged as. We've got a lot of room on the back. We can stow a lot of gear on them. We're just going to see if we can grab some more people just further towards the back here. And then we'll take them back to the marae for the huis and the kai that's going to be on. So we're quite fortunate being able to come into this area and be welcomed here to do this exercise. It's a very unique opportunity for our children to be able to do the marae experience, being in such a remote location.
Okay, so for today, part of our exercise is that we have our kitchen team, and we have to cater for 70 to 90 people today. So having our cadets over there cooking, cutting, and working with the local iwi people is helping with the civil defence exercise that we have. If they want to, if they develop the right skills, they can lead them onto careers within the defence forces, navy chefs, the top in the world, and you've got the army chefs as well.
Now, the initiative that MIT is running for me, the initiative of incinerators on marae, is to try and give people in isolated communities an opportunity of dealing with that domestic rubbish in a safe and appropriate manner. And what they're doing is looking at how they can assist us in developing tools to build resilience into communities.
Not to sound too greedy, but can one marae have all those things?
We're the Forest Research Institute. We're one of the government research institutes for research and specialising in forestry, and there's been a rural fire program based at Scion for about 25 years. As I said, more extreme weather means more severe fire danger days and longer fire seasons. So
it's so isolated up here. I mean, the community is so isolated. There's no network. I just picked that up. It's like only social network. I don't know who the go-to person is. I just found out that Victoria this morning is the civil defence person.
At the moment, they're both running parallel to each other, never meeting. You know, so that's just an avenue which could be possibly looked into.
As we know, there's still a long way to come up here. One and only resource that needs looking after up here. It's huge. What that machine is capable of doing into remote areas.
Search and rescue operation. We've heard that there's injured people at loss of campground, and so we're sending the cadets out learning about search and rescue and how to deal with an injured person if they find them with their injury of some kind.
Come over here, I'll give you a briefing. So at the moment we've got four missing people. Unfortunately their cell phone's gone dead. I've got basically been told that they're on this side of the creek, and that's about all I know.
If you are near water, what is your ratio out in the field?
1 to 10.
1 to 10. So you will be allocated, you three sections will be going out. The other group comms will be here in the yellow truck. So it is open ground, you should be able to pick it up. What is your channel?
52.
52, yes, correct.
These scenarios are extremely important to learn from, to sort out the little fine details and for when a real situation happens.
In the bush over here, a lot of same colours green. So what would stand out? Any different colours, any different shapes?
Alright, pronto, the situation is under control, over.
So do you want to leave that uncovered?
No.
With that cold wind on it?
Hey, sailor.
To Mata, to Tamata there. The patient has just arrived.
Okay. Yes. Yeah.
Make sure.
Get on the front,
okay? Yep. Make sure she's all right. There you go, sit up, lean against me. See, you just lean against them. Wherever they're comfortable, you just leave them.
Blanket.
The wind's released.
watch your stop, and that you are now coming.
She goes. Put down, take the jacket off.
Yeah. Do you really want to be pulling on that?
It's okay.
Do you really want to be pulling on that?
Up.
Yeah.
Keep talking to her.
So they found all the patients. They're stretcher carrying one and supporting the other. They've got two of the other lost parties already at the ambulance, as far as I'm aware. So we'll just see how these big boys struggle with a light person on the stretcher. So all the people are found. So now it's just a concentrated effort on getting them out. All right, let's go.
This person is bleeding out. Come on, let's go.
You guys are like walking faster. Rotate. Let's go, team.
Okay, so we're going to come past the end of the ambulance, and I want to pass head first. So I want to head first into the stretcher. Knock your head out. Knock, what's he knocked out? And then just place it.
Yeah, I've got this end.